tonight we're just going to be doing some work on the snowboard here. First things first, I'm going to go ahead and take the bindings off. This isn't something you have to do, but it does make it a whole lot easier. Gives you a flatter surface to work with. Plus, I'm going to be switching these bindings out anyways, so I don't need to keep it. I put the base plate back on just so I don't lose any screws. Set those aside for now. Flip it over. Give it a little wipe down. Any debris, things that might have gotten on there during the drive from the resort. There's no dirt on there. And then, since this lovely board has many core shots, that's where we're going to start today. Start with a little something that you don't mind dripping stuff on, specifically hot wax. Go ahead and look at the other little base repairs that kind of cracked up over time. And then we're going to get the base material nice and hot. Eventually it'll start to drip. And that's what we want. Well, I got a nice steady flame on there. Drip. And just slowly move it over the area you want. Pretty easy to extinguish, so we'll light it again. Fork drives, we're coming here with our razor blade, press that down, press that down, really push it into the base, Try and give it something to grab onto. Looks like we need a little bit more over here. Solid press. Last but not least, come over here to the other edge, which doesn't like to cooperate. Give that a quick press. Now we can come back to the first one that we put. Scrape off the excess. Trying not to get anything but the excess. As anything extra is just coming out of the core itself. We want it to be as flat as we can get it, since the next step is waxing. We seem to have accidentally taken up more than I was hoping with that one. This guy, we might just go ahead and pick out the rest of that older pair. Just start from scratch. Maybe this one will hold a little bit. Put a nice press down in there. Now I can come over here. Hopefully this one's nice and dry. Won't have any problems with it. Yeah, this one's coming up nice. That's nice. That's exactly what we want. Hopefully this one's had a little bit more time to dry. It's not going to come out all as one big piece again. We can just kind of shave the top off here. Just leave enough to cover up that nice hole. Hopefully that'll last us at least a few rounds. rest of this excess base material off of here. Deal with that later. Now we can move on to the fun part. Actually putting some wax on the board. Some people like to wax the tips and tails, but that seems like a waste of time and a waste of wax. So I usually just start at the contact points, work my way up from there. It's a little bit harder to see on these clear bases, but you just want to make sure you get all the way to the edges. Don't leave any bare spots. Another thing you want to avoid doing while waxing is just leaving your iron sitting in one place for too long, because that'll scorch the base and there's no coming back from that. So you want to just do nice light circles, or you can move up and back, but so long as you're moving consistently, methodically, not resting in one place for too long. Also, if you move slightly ahead of your working space, you can kind of warm up the wax before you get to it. That way it doesn't take quite so long and you don't have to reheat the wax on every new surface that you get to. This is a little bit easier to do with skis or a split board, because you can just move directly down it in one direction, but snowboards just take a little bit more time. But snowboards take a little bit more time with everything, so there's nothing new in there. We don't do this because we have a need to, we do this because we want to, as we love it. Not satisfying, but a good wax job is when you're out there on the slopes. You know that part of the fun you're having is due to your own hand, caring for the board, caring for yourself. And just kind of make sure you look down and make sure that there's no dry spots. If there are, you can just generally heat up the area around that dry spot and spread the wax around a little bit more. If you need to, you can come back with more wax, but I think on this job I did plenty of wax. I'm gonna have a real fun time scraping it all off. Turn that off for now.
I'm gonna wait for a few minutes while this soaks in all this beautiful wax. Come back in a few minutes and scrape it off. Then we can brush it, and then we can take a towel, get every last little bit of wax off of there. So now that we've given it an ample amount of time in order to rehydrate the base, I'm gonna start at one end. Start scraping the wax off. Seems like I might have used a little bit too much wax. That's okay. It'll all come off. It's gonna take a little bit longer than I probably needed to. Really, all I'm doing here is scraping until I feel that resistance of the wax. Once you can start feeling the scraper slide back and forth freely, so yeah, I know you have a pretty good idea that there's not much of wax left. Divots, especially on a board that's in as rough a shape as this one, where you get little scratch areas going over rocks and branches and stumps. In those areas, you kind of need to bend the scraper to fit in those divots. Once you get as much wax out of those areas as possible, you can also take these rounded edges on the scraper and kind of just run them through there. Be gentle with it when you're using the corner of the scraper though, because the last thing you want to do is gouge the base and make whatever divot or crack or crease worse than it already is. Just kind of brush this off to the end for now. Just keep working our way down. And you also don't have to worry about a ton, but it is something to keep in mind, is that the wax usually comes up over the edges, and that means that your first couple turns will be edgeless unless you go ahead and scrape those off while you're in the process. A couple different ways you can hold the scraper. This is one of them. Just kind of pushing with your palm and then dragging backwards. Generally not as effective, but it's less muscle than a two-handed approach. I'm going to be extra careful around these base patches when you're scraping the wax off. I'll have to pop those out. Sound. Now that we've done our initial pass, we can come back through and kind of search out those left behind lines. Just see where, if you're scraping around, if you see any areas where you want to put over here, you've seen a lot of wax peeling up. It's worth going back and just hitting those a little bit harder. If you feel any bumps, wire going up and down the base. find that there's some leftover wax. But that seems pretty good to me for now. Now we can just move on to the brush. Brush off the excess wax. So any little piece of wax that's on here at this point, you're gonna notice it whenever you go to brush it off the brush. Same idea with the brush, with the scraper. You can run it. Up and down until it feels smooth and you stop getting this little build up of wax. Sometimes it's helpful to get a little bit of extra pressure. Another thing that brushing supposedly does is it creates channels in the wax that allow the melting water molecules that pass underneath the board to move in a direction that you want them to move, not side to side across the board, not diagonally, but directly in the center of motion, whether you're writing regular or switch. So just to allow you to get that extra speed as you're gliding along. Hopefully through some sweet, sweet path. I that's not necessary, but I like to do it just so I can get a really good feel for the board and make sure that there's absolutely no wax left. And I just like to take the rag and run it up and down, just kind of get those last little bits of wax, and even gives it a little bit of a polish too. But if you can just have a better feel for things with the rag than you can with the scraper or with the brush, so you can really feel if there's any spots that are dragging or any really small bits of wax that might slow you down. Which is obviously what we want to avoid. I don't want all the skiers out there making fun of us for not being able to make that traverse. Or laughing at us when we get stuck in powder. That's why we wax our boards.